stream is.
Washington. Meow. Meow.
Looks like
we're on. Very good. And thank you for confirming, Michael.
Jack Bridge is also up.
Very good. Aw, sweet Remy. So. Oh, stinky Remy. Oh, well. Good evening, Internet. I forgot to switch primary display. Hold on. There we go. Good evening, Internet. It is 8:07 p.m. on Thursday, October 24th, 2019. Welcome to Thursday Thanatopsis. I'm your host, Mark Amsright, DJ Amstrak. That's Daniel. Excuse me. And tonight we will be continuing Sunless Sea. Last time we got to a lot of places that I had never been before. But 'twas exciting.
Yep, we ran all over the... No, not all over the sea. We went to Field.
We did. We went to many, many places. And this time, tonight, I am sure we will go to many more. So, let us go ahead and resume. Exactly did we leave off? I'm sure I delivered all my port reports last time. Yep. Alright, so. I can purchase an elegant townhouse. Perhaps I should save up for a better ship, though, and get the townhouse later.
Yeah, take it out. Townhouse do for you.
I think it's more effective at reducing terror than my room above the Blind Helmsman.
Mm.
did he need? Colossal Fluke Core or 7 Lamentable Relics. That one's going to be easier, I think. Unless I get very lucky.
It is indeed significantly nicer and 10 times as expensive to use.
Ooh.
100 echoes to rest, but minus 15 terror, which is 15 times the terror reduction of sleeping in the inn.
Yeah.
Minus 2 wounds.
Ooh.
2 restful nights instead of 1.
Nice.
And the reduction to yearning burning is the same. No, I should get Elijah next.
Oh yeah, thank you. I forgot.
I love that thing. And that's why I sailed my mansion out to sea. That raises more questions than it answers. Much part because such were not asked.
Okay. Port Cecil. I found that place, right? Yeah, I have. Okay, so let's take a look at the map. And track a route. So there's Port Cecil. There's Polythreme. Okay, let's Abbey Rock, Shepherd Isles, Salt Lions, Port Cecil. I don't think there's anything in particular that I can sell particularly well. Around there, but I don't recall for sure.
Frames so much right now.
Oh?
They keep sliding down my nose.
Eight or 7,000 echoes. Someplace wanted Foxfire candles, didn't they?
A few places use Foxfire candles for stuff. Like anywhere you're going into a dark place and there's light that's needed.
Yeah.
It often costs Foxfire candles to go to it.
Oh,
usually one, two, or in some cases five.
How many sacks of coffee beans did I need for the Khanate? That was the initial offering that I needed to make, was some amount of coffee beans.
Ah, and that's not like a questy thing in your life or anything?
I don't believe so, no.
Because I very much did not get that.
Yeah, nothing. Do not know. Well, let's It's a straight trade. One of your best discoveries for one of hers. It's not hard to drive the bargain. She sits back after dinner and tells you this. Most people think that the hard part of surgery is finding what's wrong and taking it out, but any fool could do that. A ship's cook with a cleaver can have that part of the job. The hard part is cutting so you can sew it all back up again afterwards. And she demonstrates on a shark fin, leaving it in a better condition than it started. I like the Blimmigan. He's cute.
Expand.
5? Okay. Cool.
If you're offering a gift to the
leopard. To the leopard?
Yes.
Oh yeah, that's right, they're animals. Or they use animal names. I was just like, I'm looking for my leopard. Where could he be? Okay. Now then, let us continue. Buy one more supplies. Looking for my leopard, looking for my fragments. Cool. Save my news for somewhere else because I don't really need a reduction in terror. Jilly Fleur. Fleur. Not Fleur. Been better, but could have been worse.
Eight points of damage. Not great, not terrible.
Yeah. Wait, that's a reference to something. What?
Chernobyl.
Oh, okay. another memory of distant shores. You heard of the Pillared Sea where Irem lies. Wise man from Irem came here, 80 years ago. He planted 3 pillars. They were as big as fingers when I were young. Now they're as you see them. In my son's time, they'll be as big as dock cranes. Okay, next to Salt Lions.
It's just so weird that those pillars are growing.
Well, whether or not to believe them is the question. It is ever the question. Loot and scuttle. Spider silk. They hurt less than the jelly floor did.
Yep, half the damage.
Mm-hmm.
Again,
must.
Those crack 4-pounders. 3-pounders?
4-pounders. What with one fat baldy yank stove a saying, God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold, we'd fire no guns. Shed no tears, but I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateers. Report. 20 units of spare cargo space. Sure don't have that.
Not on this boat.
Oh. Nice. Lost 5 terror, gained 1 fragment.
One fragment is worth fairly little.
Yeah. And for no real cost either. Okay, and straight east to Port Cecil. Jelly Fleur. I'm gonna need repairs next visit home. Okay, let it disperse. For another Z story. Thank you.
weird everything over here is named after brain bits. Gyrus.
Say something about brain coral, but it's not that. Alright, a contact in the labyrinth. The Admiral gave you directions to take to meet your contact. Left, right, down, into the labyrinth of coral outside Port Cecil, over the silvered vein, past the castellations of, to the unfinished court. Let's gather intelligence first. Here is a rubbery man, one of the squid-faced bipedal things that infest the sadder hovels of fallen London. It looks ill, or infected. The pearly glow of the coral throbs from a seam along its shoulder, its arm, pulses in its face fronds. Otho Ruth, it pipes cheerfully. It hands you a page of notes smeared with tangerine goo. Can rubbery men write? The hand is elegant and disciplined, times and dates precisely recorded. Okay, not going to chess right now, but 28% chance of success. Now let's just explore. Oh no, Dawn Machine! Let's just take cover. Or... let's do that. Gained 5 terror, 1 memory of distant shore. Okay, next. North to Khan's Glory, I believe it was. Ooh, that's a big fish.
Dow's eight.
Eight.
Strangely empty scrolls.
Let's go ahead and stop here first. Compile a court report or whatever.
Your suspicion among the blue birds as much.
As you pass an elegant house, lights blaze and shouts echo. Someone has caused a commotion, and here, you imagine, is that someone slipping over the garden wall. He loses his grip and falls. A muffled cry, and he's sitting on the ground, nursing his ankle. Assist him. He's probably up to no good, but perhaps that's an opportunity for you. Or turn him in for justice and all those admirable abstract things. It would probably reduce my suspicion were I to turn him in. So yeah, let's do that. Yes, lost 1 minute is Kaganian suspicion. Here! Lamp-bearing Burly swarm the back of the house. They drag the wall climber away. The enraged householder, grimly smiling, thanks you and tosses you a Kaganian coin.
Which is apparently worth 1 echo.
So not much material benefit, but,
reduction of suspicion.
Yeah. Offer a gift to the leopard. You meet with an effusive official in a room of blue glass and pierced porcelain. You supply the customary compliments and courtesies while he nods complacently. Finally, you present a sample of the coffee. The official comes suddenly awake, inhales the scent of the coffee, glances regretfully at the porcelain screen behind him. A watcher? He bows to you 3 times and sends you on your way. You now have 1 favors, leopard's condescension. I need 5 of those.
Is it Remy?
Aww.
Sweet kitten.
She's probably not purring quite loud enough for the microphone to pick her up, but she is purring quite loudly. Daniel. She was. Okay, so that earned me 1 leopard's condescension, and I need 5 for access to the Nephrite Quarter. So that means I need to bring 20 more bags of coffee.
That's quite a bit of coffee.
Yup. Oof. Okay, next to Frostfound, I suppose. and then east. Actually, maybe it's about time for me to turn back before it gets too, before I start running too low on supplies and also repair. Okay, create a court report. Nothing else. Nothing else. I will, however, swing a little harder north. And come back down at Mount Palmerston. It's a devil ship. This is not good. Miss. Ow!
Oh, jeez, get a fresh move.
Yeah, no, I shouldn't. But I gotta get past him. Push your engines too far, too fast. The Zalers scream, flames rage. Quickly. Succeeded in a Hearts challenge, lost two hull. up to the crater. I don't have any souls for, and I don't particularly want to concede my own, so I refuse tactfully. Gained one supplies. Unlucky, lost two supplies, gained five terror, gained one intriguing snippet, and a memory of distant shores.
Okay. We still have fast flights, just need to get some gas.
Yep. I no longer need Zoop.
And go get freaking repairs.
Do either of those other things sell particularly well in London?
Super the Invigorous Healeth?
Or Devil Bone Dice. I think I can bring Ambiguous Eolith.
Dice sell for 20.
Okay, so that's one profit.
Zoop for 70.
So that's no profit. I think I can bring Ambiguous Eoliths to the scholar as well, though I don't know what they're.
Either 1 or 70 echoes randomly.
1 or 70.
An average of 35.
So that's what I buy them for here is 35, so. Is there anything else those are they're good for?
It's a dice roll. During a thing in port season.
Okay. I won't worry about it then. They're curiosities, so they don't actually take up space. Could make straight for Vendorbite and clear that up. Actually, no, wait. Shops. I'll stock up a little more on stuff. And go the as much of the slightly longer distance as I can for the extra port reports. Oh, that is lots of ships. But the blue ones at least are friendly, I think.
Or at the very least not hostile. Is Pigmodel on the way back, my chance?
Is Pigmotel on the way back?
Pigmote Isle.
No, that's way south.
Okay.
Pig Motel. South to clear up some of this space. Bird. It's a plane. It's a bird plane. Tried the grilled troglodyte prawns. Lost 2 terror, lost 4 hunger, gained 1 fragment. Nice.
Yeah.
That's a life bird.
Oh no. Right north, right north. I gotta run to South Coast. That ought to do. Give that bird a nice wide berth. There it freaking is!
Okay, never mind the other stops, I think. It's, actually, all that's left really is Venderbite, and that's.
Potentially blocked by the berg, depending on which way it's going.
Bats.
Bats you can at least one shot.
Yeah. Which has dispersed.
Yes, his reserves are out. Can't always convert supplies if necessary.
But I don't think it will be. Yeah, no more suspicion. Collect messages. Continue. Pass on strategic information. 150 echoes. Another favor. Mount Palmerston is my next destination. Okay. Cool. I need to go record my life before I submit poor reports. I actually have a slightly better than even odds chance at submitting the Shepherd Isles report as fact. Yes, completely repair.
Yep, so boat is fully off.
Woo!
Much better.
Yes. Cool. All right. Lodges.
Do you have anything in your hold that you might want to sell to make room for more stuff?
There's the casket of sapphires, there's the spider silk, and that's in the secure compartment, and that's it.
Stupid compartment! Ah.
Eventually.
And secrets, 122 fragments. That thing that isn't a secret but kind of sounds like a secret.
Hmm?
It's the first thing right of your... Oh, and it's recent notes, never mind. Mm-hmm. That's like the juicy tidbit or whatever.
Extraordinary implication. Intriguing snippet.
Intriguing snippet. There we are. Which for some reason looks identical to recent news.
Let's see. Nah. That startled Remy. A new recruit. Sure, engage a sailor. Lost one terror. Very good.
Oh, wait, were you thinking of dropping off a sailor or two to get a claim?
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
How's that? I told us now.
Oops. Oh, well.
Because they take 3/4, I think?
Yes.
Perfect. Implications and 10 license and insurance.
Mm-hmm. Sure, why not?
Yeah, I get
Fragment and 50
fragment
Echo.
And 50 bucks.
Extraordinary implication. 250 echoes. 2 fragments. Favors antiquarian is increasing. Give them the ambiguous Aelith, because I can always get more. 70 echoes. Oh, I see the nap marks clearly. I rather think it was no human hand that shaped this either. Something from before. Or at least I like to think it. And that's what's most important. Outlandish artifact. 100 echoes. Favors increased to 3. How about captivating treasure? I don't know where I would get more of that, so if that's something that I will want at some point, and it's not taking up inventory or hold space.
Let's see, you can buy them for 11 caskets of sapphires, 1500 echoes. You get them from Events, Festival of Cure, Festival of Flourishing, The First Curator gives you captivating treasures.
Tell me.
If you can succeed in the Veils challenge against Mount Nomad. It's a captivating treasure. Open the thing.
Yes, but what is it used for?
Drops from some stuff. No, you're just like wondering what it... You'd also been wondering how hard it is to get more.
Well, no, I was expressing that I didn't know how to get more, so if it was something that it was, I would want to hold on to it if there was something useful that I wanted to save it for.
But strange. The creature name. Okay, usage. Can be used in your study, at your lodgings, to create an heirloom.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Can be used to create a shrine to stone in your study, in the townhouse. 7 of them are required to buy back someone from the Fathom King. Wow. And can be sold to Lament Army Scholar in Con Shadow for 1,000 echoes.
Such a happy Rammy. She's just kind of like kneading the air above my lap. Sweet girl.
Give it your meerkat box full of very angry dream snakes. Very angry.
Hey, yeah, that's a thing that I need to do.
The tireless mechanic's quest, apparently.
A clay man and an empty mirror catch box to Hunter's Keep. London. Carousing the docks. Nice.
Apparently the box of very angry dreamseeks counts as one of your neat bow colors. Viric.
Wait, the what does?
The box of very angry dreamseeks, after the Tireless Mechanics quest, it gets you one such thing.
Oh, okay.
Counts as the one of the available requirements for Viric.
Okay.
There are a couple of other ways.
I could get more powerful engines.
Models 1 through 3 are not discussed in polite company.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that is very clear. I guess you're nowhere near to avoiding the next boat, doesn't suck?
Nope.
Man, they're really sick of this thing for a while, aren't they?
Mm-hmm. Well, I may as well go ahead and do that. Let me get about faster.
Why in the realm would you buy 10? Hold left shift to buy 10 engines.
Yep. That sounds like a great idea.
What are you building? Some sort of boat spider? Not a wild, wild west, but boats... Don't forget to sell the old engine.
Yep. Wild Wild West.
Wiggity wiggity. So. Manticore number 4. We don't talk about dead manticores. We just don't. Okay, so what else do we need to do?
Could buy more coffee beans to take to the Khanate. But that wouldn't leave me very much.
Souls to give to the Whistleblowers.
Yeah.
These have stamped. These are stamped and not illegal.
Mm-hmm. One sec. How much did the mirror catch box cost in Polythreme?
To expand this to an Excel document. I've run out of space. Air catch box. Look, I got to look here. Mirror catch box. I'm going to spell mirror. That's weird. That. Oh, it starts with empty, of course. Of course! Of course! It's like an of course. Dunderheads. Okay, so. Where's Traveler's Friend? Is that a place you've been at?
Nope.
No, that's in Khan's Shadow.
Oh, I have been to Khan's Shadow.
Yes, but you're not allowed to purchase things from Traveler's Friend, I think.
Mm.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen the Mile Breaker. Oh, wait, actually, I think I do remember seeing him out somewhere.
Actually, hey,
yeah.
I...
Also, really friends the crew, and apparently that's necessary.
I do need to head to Mount Palmerston anyway.
Okay.
So...
You may be able to access Traveler's Friend.
Let's go ahead and buy the Crate of Human Souls.
You can also get it from the Licensed Exchange, which is where exactly? A shop that only becomes available if you have one nephrite ring. Ah, permission to trade from Consular.
Yep.
In which case, you can buy an empty mirror catch box for... No, you can sell an empty mirror catch box for 250. Here, wait. No, you can buy an engineer again. It says buys only and sells only. What do you mean by this? Does the shop buy it? Or can you? Well, that's under buy and that's under sell, so I assume the... Okay, so yeah, you can totally get a mirror catch box from there, too. As well as, strangely enough, Dark Drop coffee beans for 40 echoes a bot.
No, that's even cheaper.
But first, you have to trade a bunch of coffee beans to get the right to trade at the shop that sells coffee beans.
Of course.
Yay!
But for 40 a pop, you said?
Yep.
That would be a profit.
Fox
not much of one, but it's something.
30, supplies are 25, fuel is 15. Oof, a little costly, those. If I recall correctly. Oh, yeah. Palmerston. I've been beating hard. Traveler's Friend is a good place to get an empty mirror catch box. It's the same price as the License Exchange. And yeah. It's also a place you can purchase outlandish artifacts. And of course they sell them out.
Yes, please. Thank you.
And the boat is now a thirsty thing.
Yep, but it is so much faster.
No, that's linear.
That's a giant crab.
Massive damage.
Iron and misery.
It's their fungeing station.
Report.
It's nice to have a dedicated place to do your funging.
T, lost 2 terror, gained 1 supplies, and 9 fragments.
And that's all for now. Good night, and have a pleasant tomorrow.
Good night. No need to do that.
Have a pleasant tomorrow.
You are at 17.
Yep. A gleaming marauder is assembling an immense hoard of drowning pearls. His teeth are gold, his rings wink with scintillac. A locked box sits beside him, containing delicacies retrieved from the wisp ways. Trade a drowning pearl for 2 solace fruits. Gather intelligence.
Blimigans.
This guy's a blimigan. Let's explore. Try the grilled troglodyte prawns.
I
Oh, I can't go up and talk to her this time? Hello, hello. I have something for you. A Kaldan buzzing shape clasps your elbow. It whispers in your ear. Its breath is lava and old brass, and a queasy vibration shudders through you where its gloved appendage has taken hold. You have what you came for. Back aboard ship, quickly. Your vision blurs. Perhaps you are unwell. Dang. Okay. Let's buy a little more fuel. Mm-hmm. Hopefully let's buy a little more than that.
We could do a soulless fruit, and I see, one thing is the Merciless Beast wants it for a zoo.
Oh. You are right. Let's buy some zoop and do that.
What's that third thing, Joss?
It's just the unlocked with learning about the Merciless Medici, right. The Medici's mystery.
Hello, I-43. Says, oh boy, Morris on the sea.
Hello.
Well, somewhat more unfortunately phrased, oh boy, Morris has, but... more shiny sandwich.
Okay, back for some solace.
It tastes like light. It also emits light. It's like a photonic po' boy. Yeah, it took me a little bit to come up with a sandwich that started to pee.
And the guy's gone now, but I can still buy the stuff.
There was a guy?
Yeah, there was a guy that I could trade a thing to for two solace fruit.
Oh, oops.
Oh well, I can afford it.
One.
Yep.
Solace fruit? Nope.
Yeah. Why, Captain, I'd hope I have not been forgotten. I had a most delightful little boutique, not too far from the bazaar. Many surface commissions, naturally. Once one has sampled the cloths from behind mirrors, it is quite obscene to return to the mundanity of cotton and silk. Velvet, of course, is another matter entirely. Such a fabric! The modiste cuts a slice of fruit tart, licks the side of her knife. Oh, to show you my finest creations, I would dress you in razors and arsenic and the dream dyes of parabola. Forbidden. When my friends and I first set sail as the set, we knew no such creative cowardice. Blood and ink, my captain, blood and ink. Great art has always demanded great suffering. We simply recognize that its obligation does not necessarily have to weigh upon the artist.
I think you, did you get some terror out of that? I didn't quite catch.
I don't think I did. Let's see. Let's ask. Of course you have heard of us, my captain. We are art's last bastion against the cowardly and the mundane. We sail irrepressible beneath the waves, free of censors and censure. The muses are compass and guide. Well, when time and tides permit, of course. It has been too long since our last little salon, and the unpleasantness. The modiste adjusts the bodice she is sewing, pins it in place. Ah, but the wonders we once crafted in the waxlight. The perfidious composer, every betrayal a new operetta. The ender of critics, knives blunt as their wits. The silent sculptress, so unjustly exiled when the truth emerged about her torments of clay and bone. Such fine teas she served. Then, yes, there was the pianolist and our dear, dear poet, too, but... Her finger slips, a drop of blood flowering on white lace. Blasted, she mutters. Not even this year's red.
I mean, it won't stay red for long. It'll turn brown. And then yellow, and are you trying to clean it?
A sweating crewman stands exhausted, her arms out and wrapped in flowing parabola linen. The modiste fusses over a stretch of exquisite lace, fixing it in place with a hooked pin thrust through a pinch of convenient flesh. Oh, do stop mewling. If you want something worth sobbing about, you need only ask. She glances over her shoulder, smiling warmly. Ah, Captain, do you perhaps know if the current style in London is still to the floor, or if one might finally show a knee in polite company? No, no matter. First we will shock, then we shall inspire. Commission a new dress uniform? 3 bales of parabola linen, 1 royal blue feather, and 1 comatose ferret. Oh.
Oh no!
Not
the ferret!
Commission a set of fine clothes. Strange catch, scintillac, and spider silk.
Strange catch. Yep.
Protective armor. 2 caskets of sapphires, 3 bales of parabola linen, and 3 Stygian ivory. All right.
Oh my goodness, she makes it out of the very... Why?
Is mean.
And the ferret's pretty useless, but still, come on. That's not nice.
Alright, let's Copper Quarter to Wanderer's Haven to Hi. Godfall Hay to Commingle.
Oh yeah, because we need a
Oh my god.
Who?
Marion in her
mm-hmm.
Halloween costume. Gah.
Gabriella said, I don't look great in blades and arsenic. Yeah, razors and arsenic just sounds like a good way to get arsenic in your blood.
I mean, a lot of people in Norman have immunity, so I think you're fine. We consume enough of it already.
I have a tolerance, I'm thinking, and not much of one. Oh yeah, and regarding that ravioli you mentioned earlier. It's actually not the dense molten core, but the deep core is actually a solid ball of iron and nickel.
A solid Byron.
With molten iron and nickel around it. And
but it's still a ravioli.
Calling the lower mantle solid is like calling mud solid? It's very, like, plastic and weird. With all the heat and pressure.
And placed in a layer of solids. It's maybe more like the crust.
Yeah, nothing really gets particularly solid to hit with the sphere.
Yeah.
Send in for all the rocks. Big sphere of rock. Lobsters.
But it's still a ravioli. Or is the earth a Pop-Tart?
Pop-Tarts are ravioli.
Pop-Tarts are ravioli. Executive order. Pop-Tarts are ravioli.
Ravioli, give me that freaking wild berry. So I can put it in my esophagus.
You know what?
Mm-hmm.
It'd be great if the weather wasn't awful and my eczema wasn't broken out. I'm dying.
Yeah, the weather is such an arse. It's a terrible, bad.
It's cold and rainy.
I wounded myself in the cold rain, actually. Very stupid. I was zipping through the rain to my car because I need to go to another building to do a thing at 5 of all strange hours.
My hair got wet enough between the walk from the house to the car.
I needed a drink, so I brought my soda, 4:30 soda with me. I shoved it in my cargo pocket because that was the place to put it, right? You can keep the koozie dry and such. Apparently, that put the lid just barely within the swingy arc of my left hand.
Oh no!
And I caught the thumb knuckle blazingly hard. Tearing the skin open, and it just sort of sat there and oozed, making an increasingly dumb-looking mess.
Increasingly dumb-looking mess. That is a mood. That is a description of me on any given day.
Oh, false.
Isk shaven.
It's a trireme. I'm just gonna avoid you guys.
Go away unfinished. Don't want to fight you.
Will they eventually just
shut the hell off?
Well, fortunately, I'm faster than them now, so.
Should rename your Boat the Blue Streak. Possibly the Gas Guzzler.
Yeah, I should have bought more fuel.
Luminescent beasts like eyeless dolphins play in your wake.
Report. Shops.
You can't afford them.
No, but I don't have the thing anyway.
You don't have what?
I don't have the stuff anyway. And where's the light box thing? The mirror catch box. I thought I could buy that here.
Ooh. Oops. That was in the kind.
Oh.
Kansar, the traveler's
friend. Gotcha. Well, I can carry dudes to place, at least.
Cecil, so I guess?
I don't remember.
Oh no. Miscalculation danger.
Mm-hmm. Ah, there's this spot right here. They sell fuel. At double price.
But can it fuel my ego?
No.
Oh, well, then what's the point? Ugh! I need chocolate.
Ah. Oh, you know you can't license exchange. Dark side. Come
here. Bring me one.
Sure, thanks. Sure, thank you. Harbors, butts, wither.
My allergies make me deaf.
Thank you.
Geidersborn sells them for 30.
Yeah. Does Nutmit harbor?
Iron Public. Of course Iron Public has a good thing.
Nope.
House of Hams? Oh, Harms. House of Hams.
Commingle.
I want to hold your ham. I want to hold your ham.
I want to hold your ham.
That sounds butt related.
Yeah. Yes.
Grim Sanders.
That is.
Jonah's toilet. Preening sandwich. You okay?
My butt was grabbed.
Mark, sir.
And I made a delightful noise. It's okay, my butt was made.
Does
for all.
Port Cecil or Nutmit Harbor?
Port Cecil or what?
Nutmit Harbor.
Whatever.
Nupmit.
Nupmit it. Sea of Frogs.
Mm-hmm.
The Low Church and Library at Low Barnett sells it for Tales of Terror. Jonah's Toilet. Nook. Khan's Shadow. Traveler's Friend has it for 15.
But I don't have access to that yet.
Traveler's Friend, I think, is the one you do have access to.
Ooh. Hello, Remy. How are you? I have a protein bar.
Barbecue.
It's got 3 egg whites, 6 almonds, 4 cashews, 2 dates. No BS.
Old fashioned herding.
2 dates? That's more than I've had in a long time.
I've forgotten how.
I'm not sure I ever knew.
Like, right now I'm seeing Robin, and literally it was us drunk at the staff party, and then Robin saying, "Someone find me a girlfriend," to which I threw myself into the room abruptly and said, "I volunteer as tribute." And that's how that went. It's been great.
I do not trust those things to sail over them.
What, the faces?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I was gonna ask earlier, like, what happens if you sail into the mouth of one?
I don't know, but I don't trust it.
But could you try?
That pirate boat might have gas on board.
It might.
Dead.
It doesn't know how to fight. Wow, that was dumb. You could have traded blows, but it's like, nope, I'm gonna derp.
Oh no. Who's the real pirate here?
Oh, it's the flare using Dunkus that keeps sailing into his own flare. Bonk. He's so brightly lit and frequently shot. Fire. Those flares let you, fire and solutions. Give you fire and solutions frequently. Oh, he's so stupid!
Again, who is the real pirate here?
I mean, I only pirate pirates.
Finish it. Oh my goodness, how in the heck?
Not quite.
How was their hold not failed?
There. It's the pirate poet again!
Her again!
Have an officer rescue her.
Strange.
Let's try it.
Yes!
Yay, 400 echoes, 1 fuel, 1 supplies.
New total, 2.
Mm-hmm. Okay, turn off the lantern to save fuel.
I feel like she's not a very good pirate.
Mm-hmm.
Or at least she has great difficulty finding guns for ships. Because that one gun she had sucked. Like, it has a lot of HP, but it's barely doing anything when it hits. Salt Steps, and a new continent whose ancestors came here long before London fell. There's no poem celebrating a victory, though.
Okay, here we go. There's the mirror catch box, too. Let's bring myself back to 5 fuel, which will definitely get me to Mount Palmerston. Or, actually, you know what? That's pretty far out of my way. I will buy the mirror catch box. Okay. A mirror catch box full of very angry dream snakes.
Very angry.
A sullen viric glow leaks from within.
Sometimes it rattles.
Okay. Port Cecil, Zealport, Station 3. No, there hasn't really been anything else of interest in Station 3, Fieldhaven, then.
I-483 says, super angry.
Soup? They're angry.
Soup?
Soup.
It's soup.
Why are you buying pants at the soup store? What is that angry looking thing?
It a fish.
It's the size of the boat.
Uh-huh.
It bigger than the boat.
That's why I'm avoiding it.
You should see the bound sharks.
I've seen them.
They're caught in iron, so you think they wouldn't be that dangerous. Because
then I also commented on the fact that I'm super scared of sharks.
You should see the weird eyeball frogs out at the Sea of Lilies. I thought they were really cute until I realized the spots were eyes.
Uh-huh.
Like, oh no, they're peeping now. Oh, they're peeping.
Port Cecil. Gather intelligence. And explore. Citizen, I'm a good Z-man. I'm yours if you'll have me. Will you have me? I'm hungry. I'll work hard. Yeah, okay. I'll go ahead. Huh.
be as much fragments as discovering an island.
Nice.
483 says, oh boy, chessport.
Yeah, I've played a few times, but I'm up to the point where it's,
if you get good enough, it's a source of Applesand.
Apossian?
I get a feeling it's Applesian.
Right, it's a color, but...
Yeah.
Oh, my face.
It's one of those colors, in fact.
I reached up to scratch my face, and I've apparently got, like, a tiny little hangnail, and it just, like, jab. Mm. Right in my cheek.
Yeah, sometimes I get, like, a super pointy, jaggy bit on my nail.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just, like, slash. Ah! So I just cut myself open. I just cut myself open!
Every time I think, man... It'd be really nice if I could, like, go get my nails done, get some acrylics, get some, like, cat scratchy bits. And then I realize I work with children and I jab them in the eyes a lot.
That would be bad.
It would.
You don't want finger blades of children.
I didn't even get my nails done when I got married because I was afraid of stabbing my children.
I can see taking an every board and smoothing and rounding and safing, peace binding.
Peace binding my nails.
put little corks on.
All right, Salt's right. The face of the Northern Sphinx is all but gone. Salt's voice is distant but clear. Let's do that. That sounds interesting.
You're a cat.
Dive from the Sphinx's face down a clean arc into the Z's chilly darkness. Float there in the quiet until your lungs are bursting, until light blooms behind your eyes. Rise gasping to the prickle of false stars, the shocked faces of your crew. You've brought something with you.
Okay.
Gained Salt's 7 terror, gained an extraordinary implication.
And you lost Salt's intention.
Salt's attention.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever that might be. I honestly don't know how the world is. Okay, I get the feeling the attention of the gods of disease is probably bad, so maybe losing it was good.
Maybe.
Hello, Rembrandt. You do not want this. It has chocolate.
I have a sleep.
It is tainted with chocolate.
Pat, pat, pat.
Head pets. Oh no. Another one of these guys.
So... how exactly are they fighting you? Oh, okay, they do have a gun.
They have a gun.
They have a gun.
Oh, this is a normal one. Okay. Yeah, they actually hit before.
Hello. What was that?
Send the point of action that close. Like, someone should have warned us at that point.
Mm-hmm.
Investigate the wreckage.
Her again!
Have an officer rescue her. 200 echoes that time. One fuel, one supplies.
F-43 says, oh boy, an extraordinary implication. That's important. Man, no, this is the pirate boat again. Sure was! How important are extraordinary implications? I know they're quite as rare and valuable as stuff like searing enigmas, but...
two supplies. I'm not going to have to buy more supplies the next trip home.
Well, they aren't super easy to acquire outside of purchasing them. Yep. Results the alarming supplier for favors of Varian. Five of them can be traded for the Searing Enigma. The rest hoarded for Searing Enigmas are sold at Roser's Wharf.
So, infrequently and unreliably.
What?
Roser's Wharf sells stuff, like they only have two trades at a time.
Oh, yes.
Available randomly, basically.
But it's fine, these are curiosities.
Abbey Rock. Down at Abbey Rock.
And it can be used to purchase fancy things.
Now
like
I really want to watch Froggle Rock.
A star
I miss that
shell
show.
And the figurehead
Froggle
of
Rock
beans.
Has become my favorite curse word in class.
Dance cares away. Worries for another day. Let the music play. Down at Abbey Rock.
Man.
I-43 says, as a tip, normal pirates don't turn very quickly and don't ever reverse or shoot players. Only the pirate pilot does.
Oh, okay.
Hey.
That explains things.
Is it better to release her in person or have a crew member do it?
I'm gonna go throw myself a bed.
Okay, good night.
I have to force myself to go to work tomorrow.
Don't throw yourself too hard. Last time I did something like that, I had to go get some clamps and Gorilla Glue.
The clamps.
Clamp!
Give him the clamps.
The clamps!
I broke my childhood bed by throwing myself into it like I used to all the time.
Yeah, John broke my antique bed.
Apparently I weigh too much and am too energetic of a creature to do that anymore. This is bad.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go buy some cheap 50-cent clamps from an Ace Hardware that isn't there anymore. A thing of Gorilla Glue that I'll never use for anything else.
Yeah. My really nice, like, antique furniture set that included my vanity, the dresser that I have in my room. Oops. And my bed frame. It was all matching. And one day, like, I was laying in bed, mostly asleep, and John jumped into the bed and the entire bottom half just collapsed. And I was basically hurled into a sitting position. Or standing position, rather. And we were both too tired, we just slept like that. I think I fell off the bed at one point.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, no, it was
I'm sure he was epic mortified, like...
Grab.
It was very sad. I
didn't think that was gonna break.
Small crib.
Well, it was the antique. Of course it's gonna break. Don't jump on it. Okay. Anyway.
Anyway.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Good night.
Hey, 25 fragments. They aren't made of rubbery men.
Ooh. F-R-A-3 says, maybe honestly not sure. Pirate Pod, until relatively recently, had been a Kickstarter-only thing, so I haven't played it since that much.
Hmm.
That explains why we had not encountered her last year?
2 years ago.
Yeah, last time I played.
The Blind Bruiser. Once more, we find ourselves here on the quayside, what is, I suppose you might say, the lip of the Well of Opportunities. Let us both drink deeply from this well, by which I mean my patron has a task for you. Take a payment across the ocean and bring back a little package. Of course, if you return to London without the little package, I will probably have something sharp to say about it. Certainly. Gator's Morn. I know where that is, at least.
Yes, this will be a strange quest into the black.
Yes.
Sorry, I got a little desperate towards the end, actually.
Mm-hmm.
I suppose you should probably unload your claimant.
Yes.
To free up inventory before you start gathering stuff.
Actually, wait, is it... Deliver claimant. There it is. 120 echoes.
You actually need less crew if you want to pick on a claimant. If you get it in there. Woohoo! My center.
Nice. Strategic information.
Invisible eyes. What do they see?
And next one is at Port Cecil. Cool. Now submit port reports. Gator's Morn, Hunter's Keep, Mount Palmerston, Port Cecil.
They're worth varying amounts. Interesting.
Godfall, yep. Shepherd Isles, Khan's Heart. Abbey Rock, Polythream, Khan's Shadow.
Ooh, Lost Terror for that one.
Nice.
Their officials gather. Oh yeah, because everybody has fun.
Mm-hmm.
Making fun of the Khan.
Quaker's Haven.
Demo's Gate? The Demonstration Gate. your ship is down 19 HP.
Hmm. It should be fine for now. Sixteen fuel, that'll last me a bit. Don't need to get more supplies since I move so fast now. I need to go record my life, though.
take a peek at the Roser's Wharf. Nope. Watchful Curio and moves in the great game. Okay, now I need to stop at Gatorsborn and Port Cecil. So let's go Hunter's Keep, Demo Island, Gatorsborn, Copper Quarter, Shadow, Port Cecil, and back that way. Ooh, an unexpected letter. I am a father. I am a father.
And you found that out by letter?
Oh, you can actually choose.
Yeah.
Like either you sire the child.
Yeah, I'm the father, I'm the mother, or it's
taken in a foundling. Oh,
okay. Yep.
Is that the kid?
Uh huh.
Okay. Well, she took a long time to tell you if you're a father.
I think the idea is that I received the letter, like, out at sea, but I happen to be in London right now anyway, so.
A new life. A funny looking new life.
You, your sweetheart, and your child. What will your child call you? Nothing at all. You don't want to raise the child, or you can't afford to. Turn away, let your sweetheart raise the bread if they can. Oh, improve your lodgings first. You can't raise a child in a room above a pub. Well, people do, but your sweetheart expects better. Okay, then. I guess I'm purchasing the elegant townhouse.
It's like that. I think you still have the money for the baggage, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. That and not much more, but yeah.
I-43 says, I found a baby! Completely unattended.
Captain, your relationship will be remote or complicated or exceptional. Here it is. Small, warm, apprehensive, affectionate creature. Treat it gently.
You may visit all day your lodgings when you gain a free evening. You always get free evenings when you return to London, but here's one now.
Time with your family. Ooh. It's a delight, but will it always be a delight? The Zaler knows two worlds. If you give suitable presents to your child, they will gain sea fever. If sea fever reaches 25, they will decide to run away to sea, becoming your scion. This will establish a permanent dynasty of future Z captains. Nice. Tell tales of far lands. I have so many memories of distant shores.
Gabrielius says, treat it gently? Nah, we're teaching it to be a sailor right now.
lost 5 terror and 5 memoirs Z fever. Your child's eyes grow round as pennies. They store up the memories as dream fuel. Much later, you find the scene you described scrawled on a foolscap sheet by a childish hand.
You treat my grandbaby good. It may be the only one I ever get.
What, the cats don't count?
Okay.
So many memories of different swords. What are their fours?
Well, I just used one.
Oh, that was a memory of different story, not like a Z story or anything?
Yeah. I could also use Z stories, but I have so many memories of distant shores that I opted to do that instead.
So many.
You know, I think I will go up to Fort Mount Palmerston first.
There's a veritable cornucopia of...
In fact, I'll take the north route through Venderbite, Wither, and Codex as well, and refuel at Mount Palmerston. Nope, that's not what I wanted.
Much like Z-Story, this item is arguably worth more than it can truly be exchanged for. You can't just buy them in bulk. And with the vast number of uses for them, you're quite likely to run out. Of course, there's also the last number of opportunities to gain them, and that's where the catch is, to gain more than you typically have to forego getting something more valuable than your cell price. Oh, yeah. Goddamn, they're everywhere. Good lamps.
Yeah, I can't buy too much, so I will just...
7 of them in the Mangrove College to do something. Here's one to assemble vital intelligence.
And I'll get that back when I sell those. Okay.
Use one in the Sapphire Chamber of the... Yeah, I know where that is. That stupid castle of frozen doom. I think that was the one thing you actually had. Woo! And consume 77 to write the song of the Z. The song. All these Z's are getting a little bit zoopy. Give your child a pet. One live specimen. It is remotely possible that it will escape and eat someone. Probably just a parlor maid. Your child is disinclined to hug it, but its tank will take pride of place in their bedroom. Its staring eyes and pulsing fangs will inspire glorious fantasies of Z-monster hunting. Pulsing. Yep. Give your child a judgment's egg. That's safe. It will coil and glow silently on their nightstand. It's a bit of a peculiar thing to give to a child, honestly.
I'll say.
Apparently your child wants to become salt. One day your child breathes, eyes wide and fixed, gleaming in the soul light. I will set this at the bow of my ship. I will sail east for always until the sky goes out. That cost us 15 Z.
Ooh.
Oh, you can lose 20 Terra regardless. Just enjoy their company, also. Consumption is there.
Oh, that's a lifeberg. Flee.
An excellent source of supplies, which you don't need.
Yeah. Okay. Offer the shivering monkeys a lamentable relic. 3 unread logs. That sounds interesting. I know I need lamentable relics for something, but that sounds very interesting. An irritable monkey snatches the relic and cradles it to the matted fur of its chest. Another, from a cautious distance, flings 3 logbooks at you, one after another. Each is filled with scientific field notes, this one of Z soundings, this one of angler crab behavior, this one cataloging the fossilized sigils of Codex.
Thanks, monkeys!
Yeah. I don't know what those are for.
Yeah, stupidest thing about the Doom Monster Hunters there.
Mm-hmm.
Their ammo.
Wait, what?
Their kind of ammunition. It's so silly. And dark.
Yeah. What?
They do huge amounts of damage to Z creatures. And they're very expensive.
Very expensive, Douglas. Wither. Gather intelligence. Discovered Odinson Straits.
Oh.
Hadn't.
Lifebergs can drop on red logs.
Huh.
worth 20 echoes to the scholar. And there's a port somewhere that they can get you access to. One per day. And use it to fulfill some strange requirement of a thing at a place you haven't met yet. Huh. Okay.
A thing that I... at a place that I haven't been to yet. That is...
I'm trying not to needlessly spoil it.
No, I know. I'm just saying that's like the story of this game.
I only read the child spoilers because holy crud, that was funny. And weird. And something you probably weren't going to do.
Not anytime soon, at least. Maybe the Devil Lady will be about this time. And I can offer her those souls.
Which are presently just taking up space in the hold uselessly.
Yep. Near Mount Palmerston. You'd think it would ward that off.
Yeah, it's a cold day down below.
I see. Yup. There we go. Go up to the crater. Case of souls. I do. The deviless lifts the lid of the crate. The light from the souls within illuminates her face. She stares at them for a long moment, and then tears begin to roll silently down her face. "Thank you," she says. "I've missed them so." One of her tears lands on the wood crate, which begins to smoke. "Let me tell you something very special," she whispers in your ear. Her breath smells like hot stone, but you should go now. "Thank you. Come back soon." Gained one whole secret.
That's the whispering. It was a secret.
Mm-hmm. Myself 1,000. There we go.
Thirsty engines.
Yep. Thirsty, but so much faster now.
Anything worthwhile? Noble expedition?
That's where I'm at.
Oh, okay. That's where I'm at. The in ruins.
Well, let's take a look. was fortunate. Outlandish artifact, memory of distant shore, gained three lamentable relics.
Hey, have five.
Yes. Just need two more.
Why do you need some?
For the dude back in Fallen London.
Oh yeah, Mr. I Like Seven of Things.
Yes. Now, south to Gator's Morn.
I just dearly hope he doesn't decide that he wants seven to zoom.
That was the first thing that he wanted.
Oh. Seven searing enigmas.
That would be difficult.
Reward, it better be good. Those are rare endgame tokens. Well, me really quick, so valuable there.
Mm-hmm.
For seven, it'd better get you something cool, like a weird gun or that neat engine.
Hmm.
Something else can see the weird gun. And boy, is that gun. Cold. Take them from me. Take them. Oh, crud.
Yep. Ah, here's the guy trading drowning pearls for solace fruits.
Ah.
But I feel like I wanted something else for those, drowning pearls, but I forget what. Are Solus Fruits curiosities, though?
No, they are definitely trade items.
Okay.
They smell like a trade item because you can buy them. Oh no, it's a curiosity.
Hmm.
From the fingers of the drownies. So you can get them in all sorts of ways, and you use them for getting solace fruit from that guy. Five for offering a gift to the Tymon. And seven plus a bunch of other crazy stuff for the Brisk Campaigner's quest. With someone you haven't met.
So wait, I need how many?
What were you wanting them for?
That's what I'm asking.
Oh. Five. I'm just gonna say five.
Okay.
Because you have Metaverse Campaign, so you're probably thinking of trading them in at Khan's Glory for Tymon Favors.
That's right.
The Tymon's Mercy. Which reduces Kaganian suspicion. I-43 says Cannoneer has a good quest line.
Oh, yeah? Oh, I will need to get some torpedo components to have dinner
one.
With him.
Why do you have one?
I'm not sure.
Is it in your hold? Surely it's not a curiosity. That'd be weird.
It's a curiosity.
Okay. I guess torpedoes don't take up hold space. Interesting.
That is good.
What else do you need? He wanted like several
it was
things.
Like tin fuel and supplies.
What is he up to?
I don't know.
Well, I presume making an interesting gun.
Likely. Would you grab me a cherry 7-up, please? Thank you. Thank you. I have just enough money to pay a storyteller. I think I'll do that. That sounds like it could be interesting. The temptations of Parabola, where London now stands, the capital of the Khanate once stood, after its own disappearance from the surface. After the clean sky and wide earth, they went half mad in the close night under the earth. They found serpent things in mirrors that promised them diversion, escape, new horizons. In time, the mirror serpents became masters, not servants, and the last true Khan led the last of his people to the salt steps, to a black rock where he founded this city. How he built it is a tale for another day. You feel eyes upon you. A woman in a white and gold uniform watches you closely. The loyalty service is suspicious of foreigners who want to learn Kaganian history.
Come on!
I got a memory of distant shores. Turn him in, and lose some menace, and gain an echo.
Alright. So the continent's original capital was where London now stands.
Apparently.
Weird. I wonder if that's where the bazaar came from. I wonder if it predates even that. Clearly trusting the mirror serpents was not the best idea.
Indeed.
I assume those are dream snakes that you can catch in a mirror catch box.
Yeah.
Making them very angry.
Port report. South. Port Cecil. From you.
Sorry, Ms. Jackson.
I am for eels. Oh, and there's another one.
Never it's meant in there, two more as well.
Never meant to make your daughter cry. I am several fish and not a guy.
I assume was fleeing eels.
Do you know what that sound is, Your Highness? Those are the freaking eels. Contact in the labyrinth. Rubbery man.
Rubbery torment.
Report. Explore. A privateer encampment. This was an empty clifftop above the bleak waves. Now it blazes with color. Striped tents, colored flames, the music of pianola and kettle drum. Mustachioed women and languorous men play chess, carve bones, eat cats, and polish their terrifying brass weapons. These are Iron Republic privateers, pirates whose practices contravene the very laws of nature. Attack. They are numerous, but lost to wine and music. You will have the element of surprise, but it's very hard to know exactly what those weapons will do. 50% chance of success. Or creep close and eavesdrop. 94% chance of success. Let's go with that. They are speaking of a raid on the Khan's glory, from which they stole pieces of prayer, of a boast that a rival band made about stealing the Empress's wedding dress, of a sort of spiced meat which fills the heart with love. But they speak, too, almost coherently, of privateer lairs in the Western Wall, of passwords in use, of brass embassy protocols, and of tuning techniques for drawing lost souls close. A buzzing rises in your brain as you listen until your eyes become unfocused and your tongue feels thick and heavy. You creep away before anything worse can happen. But this is an odd and useful miscellany of facts. 47 fragments, not bad. Anything else here? No.
If anything goes particularly ill in this run, I say next run should be a Blemigan run. Just put Blemigans on every port.
A Blemigan in every port. Oh no.
Ooh, energetic heal.
Break line of sight. All clear.
You've escaped.
Report. Visit the Unmakers. terrors. Lost 5 terror, gained 1 fragment. Next, Shepherd Isles.
The equation for steel consumption is a small fraction of engine power times 1 minus fuel efficiency times gear speed plus light. Drain per second in percent. The ship's light consumes 1% of fuel every second, regardless of speed. Half speed, speed 2 is full speed. So if you use the compulsion of 3500 engine power, you'll use 1.75% fuel at half speed of lights off, 2.75% per second half speed of lights on, and 3.5% full speed of lights off, 4.5% with full speed of lights on. If you use the Fulgent Propeller, 5,000 efficiency, you get dramatically better efficiency.
Yeah, for supplies.
In short, there is no additional efficiency to be had by choosing to go at half speed versus full speed. At half speed, if you're power off, you'll consume half as much fuel over time, which is twice as long as you can cover. Same amount of fuel relative to distance. If you're powered on, you'll actually lose more fuel relative to distance when traveling solo. Good to know.
Mm-hmm.
Like your engineer gives you no boost to efficiency, does he?
5% boost to efficiency.
Oh, it is?
Mm-hmm.
Good, good.
It's the other one who gives me power instead. for the cargo and claim your payment. Oh, very good, very good. Please accept this small token of my thanks, and please also accept my thanks. And my patron's thanks, which we being persons of honor, what understands the true nature of dealings, is much more important. Still, spending money is always good, isn't it? And a captain must eat, and so must a ship, which is why if you look under the pier there, you will find a few helpful contributions of fuel and so forth.
Hmm. 200 echoes
to
Olafest.
Yep. Chapel of Lights. I've been there before, but I don't think in this run.
Somewhere northeast of London.
Mm-hmm.
Time to explore stupid depths, darkness, derps. And see what's out there. I bet it's bees. Stupid undersea bees. Sea bees and thread fleas.
No, that's not what I meant to. Your lodgings. Ooh, I need 7 secrets. And I could make a shrine to stone.
What's that do?
I don't know.
Contact Serene Aquarium. Monstrous Almanac.
That sounds interesting. Save up outlandish artifacts for that. A whispering trophy case. 7 strange catches.
And 0 tales of terror? What?
No more whispering trophy cases.
Oh.
Right a will. The Court of Chancery, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom it may devour. Ensure it doesn't get its lion tentacles on your property when you're gone. Should you die, this will ensure that your heir retains your lodgings and any heirlooms you've accumulated. That sounds like a good thing to spend money on. Go. Achievement unlocked. Sound mind. The lawyer peers at you like a vulture composed of crocodiles. Come now, she creaks. There's a few years in you yet, but your condition does you credit. Sign here. No, no, ink is fine. This isn't the brass embassy.
A adorn your lodgings with captivating treasures.
Ooh.
Convert them into heirlooms, and they'll adorn your lodgings until the day you die. After that, your family will probably sell them.
This is a way to pass money to your next character. You can have no more than 12 heirlooms, or 16 in a mansion, and you'll need to pay a small fee to write these treasures into your will. 10 echoes, and I can spend the captivating treasure.
Neat.
Into that. Or 10 outlandish artifacts at a time. Write the Zong of the Z. Need a lot of stuff for that.
Bunch of poor reports, apparently.
Yeah.
And, yeah, 77 memory citizen swords, I think it was.
Mm-hmm. Something like that. I'll save up some secrets for the Shrine to Stone, because that sounds interesting. But I'm going to go record my life again.
Because I'm drinking so much.
Oof. Okay, I have the mirror catch box. I need to go get Clayman.
What's your engine power right now?
What's my what?
What's your engine power?
2,000.
So solid is just GK.
Invite the cannoneer to dine with you. I've had enough to eat, thank you. I don't eat much, but I'd like to demonstrate some ideas I've had. Can you meet me on the afterdeck at 8 bells? The cannoneer has found ways to calibrate your weapons for additional death and explosions. When the smoke clears, however, it is impossible to deny that the risk and expense of most of these tricks is a little too great. Only a couple of minor modifications are safe to use. But do you know, the cannoneer says, squinting thoughtfully, it reminds me of a story. The Iron and Misery Company were testing something, destroyed one of their outlying stations, destroyed it to bits. If you can find me the prototype, I can make it work for us. Can you take me to Demo Island? I used to know the factor there. He might talk. Cool.
So, lamp off, your field consumption is about 1% per second. 2% per second of lamp off.
Okay. Cool.
It was less than that when you had a crappy engine.
Hmm.
And presumably more when you're using your other engineer.
Okay, what was... That's right, Chapel of Lights, which I haven't found this run.
And inconveniently, it is 11. Not that it matters all that much.
Not really. I do kind of want to keep going.
You could choose to press up.
Maybe one more... one more excursion.
Somewhere to Narius. So it could be north of Demo. Could be out past Frostfound.
Well, I need to go to Demo Island anyway, so... Let's,
Can you have some wine for Vendibite?
Nah, I'm just going to head straight there, I think. How much space do I have in my hold? Oh, wait, I used up a lot of fuel. For his info.
Oh, okay. Definitely buy some fuel then.
Or possibly get some from the other thing. Yeah.
There's
the letter. 14. That's good. And I'm probably fine for supplies, especially if I stop off at a place on
no,
the way.
Harf.
Harf, it's the same things it's been. Right. 10,000 echoes for a Z-side mansion. Actually, maybe I should buy a little more supplies.
Supplies!
Buy another 5 things of coffee, too.
That's awesome.
There we go. Call that good. Yeah, that's the what I need, the mirror catch box.
Oh, okay.
And the
lock.
Yeah. Go. Lost 10 terror, gained 1 supplies, lost 28 hunger, 2 memories of distant shores, and Stone's attention. Anything else here? Nothing I can do.
weird, but
with a normal amount of HP.
Prisoners, honey. What can I do with that?
Check to make sure there isn't any prisoner's cheese at the bottom of it.
I'm not sure I want to know.
Come on, it's a Winnie the Pooh reference!
Prisoner's cheese?
There could be cheese at the bottom of this honey, I'd better check.
I don't remember that.
It's one of those classic bouts of tomfoolery.
Okay. Oh no, I need 200 echoes.
What?
I need 200 echoes to do the bargain with the factor for a secret. I can sell it in Gator's Morn, can't I?
Let's see, you can sell it at Wolfstack for 20, sell it at the Iron Limpet, in the Corsair's Forest for 26. Iron Limpet is Gator's Morn, yeah.
Okay, cool. Then I think that is what I shall do.
It can also be Shadowy Work in the Khan's Heart, the Magician's Quest. Lifting Storm's Curse, which is not a problem, presently. Open the Way to the Forgotten Quarter. Is that a thing in the cup? No, it's... Ah, okay. Is that a magician thingy? Hey, you're a butt! You're farting, oscillating butt.
Oscillating.
You're usable in a place called the Utter Shroom for stuff. Carnelian Shnaggins. There are some things it is used for, but it can also be acquired fairly easily. Which means it might just be worth selling.
Yeah.
Since you can up and buy it in London for 25. With one less, they can sell for it. They can sell it in the Ghost's Forest. We're looking for didn't happen to be in the convenient place?
Nope.
Somewhere east of Frostfowl, like.
Yep.
No, that's a firkin of red honey that they buy there. Oh, here's... Okay, Aaron Limpid. Prisoner's honey. Har har. And of course, now I have 200 echoes.
Easier.
Mm-hmm. No, I have stories for you. Lost 2 terror, gain 50 fragments. That works. Well, I hadn't spotted the iron quarter yet.
Oh, well, got a secret.
Cool. Favor. That's right. That's what I need the 5 drowning pearls for. Okay. Let's mount Palmerston first. Because I am running low on fuel.
Gas in the line.
Having trouble with that, that thing there? That buoy? Light buoy?
Sucks
out of here. The Thule's rage. Hello, Vance.
Okay, go up to the crater. She pours the tea with a shaking hand. Her eyes are distant. The lights, the agonies, the scalding mists of lead. I miss them so. I long to return from exile. I was such a fool. There's no future with the convention. Will you help me? I overhear things here at the gate. The convention's plans. Take them back to London for me. The officialdom of hell will show gratitude to me, and I will show gratitude to you. She hands you an envelope. Unsealed, she points out. I choose to trust you. She's certainly lying. Devils do not trust. Currents. Very interesting. Of?
You want to have enough left over to get the thing.
To get the what?
The claimant.
I don't think I've had that. I don't think I've had enough this whole trip.
Okay.
I think they're 250. Now, those don't cost me anything. Those are just a delivery.
Yeah, those make you money in exchange for inventory space on the way home.
Yep. So I'm going to go ahead and buy quite a lot of fuel. Next, Frostbound. Oh heck, I just noticed that the overlay hasn't updated in a long time.
Ooh, sometimes port reports are weird. Interesting.
How do you mean?
But in polyphrene, there's a 25% chance of a rare event. It's a port of port. Which gives you some fragments. And terror to go with your port of port. Not much there, just that. But you know, it's there.
Yeah. Voids approach. The air crackles with frosty radiations. To the north, false stars fail in the darkness.
Unless you see of your violet murder fungus, it seems to be flirting with a fanged water pump.
That It's a Lifeberg. Discovered a Lifeberg from Void's approach. Gained 20 fragments. Chapel of Lights. The Kisagar Vortex. Nothing of the movements of fleets or cargoes or armies, he tells you, but your admiralty will learn the names of those who came here and what they did. Let me whisper it in your ear. Ooh. Gained a tale of terror and a fragment as well. I can eat of the chapel's bounty, but my hunger levels aren't that high. Gather intelligence.
Smelling priest does a thing.
Five supplies, I have seven. That's a little dear right now, I'm afraid. But I will remember that.
Very nice. 250 extra engine power, which doesn't really do you that much good anymore if you're a good old engine. But also 5 iron. Because the amount of crew members your ship requires in order to be able to travel at full speed is always half of the ship's maximum crew rounded up, reducing the maximum crew by equipping
We Are Clay
will also reduce the minimum required crew for full speed. Be aware that if you're at or near your maximum crew when you equip We Are Clay, any extraneous crew will be lost permanently without any warning. That's how you get rid of extra crew. Just equip the Clayton. It's fine. They'll just get off. And I'm sure. Just live there now, I guess.
Yes, yes, this is what the rumors meant. A hunter frozen in the ice, hands contorted to claws, mouth agape. With her left hand, she had plucked her own eye from the socket. It lies very close to the surface of the ice. If the stories are true, there's dark virtue in that eye. Take it then. But perhaps you should put it in a jar. Now I have one hunter's eye. Whatever that is.
Yeah, so it's the eye of something that hunts things.
Found Irem. Pillared City. Coffee. Payment in coffee? Yes, please. Sacrifice a lamentable relic. Trade a lamentable relic for 2 moves in the great game. That might be worthwhile, considering someone at the, place wants to move in the great game, but I am saving up the lamentable relics. Let's just compile a port report. When you will sit down to write the report, you will recall that it was written already. Who wrote it? The report records that it was already written when it was found. Who found it? The report describes another report, which will indicate the name of the finder. Where is the other report? There is a footnote which describes when you will record its location. When will that be? When all is well and all manner of thing is well.
Irem is silly.
Uh-huh. I can trade Dark Drop coffee beans for parabola linen? That is a really good deal. I can straight up buy lamentable relics for secrets.
Oh yeah, Lost Market's pretty cool. Like, yeah, trading secrets and such. For instance, an empty meerkat's box.
Mm-hmm. But I already have one of those. I can buy a strange catch. Can buy Tales of Terror.
You can trade a Dread Surmise for a,
for 10 Searing Enigmas. I can buy Searing Enigmas for Extraordinary Implications.
You get Visions of the Surface in turn. In return for your memories of the stores.
And I can straight up buy secrets.
For 999 echoes a pop. Woof!
What a very interesting market.
That's just Fisher of Dawn, I think. Did you check out?
I was looking in all of them.
Yeah, Windcomb Calling is the crazy one. The Threshold's nuts, too. I forget what deck you can sell that Captivating Treasure for. It's 50 of something.
Fuel.
It's a lot of gas.
Mm-hmm. I can't carry that much. That would be wasteful.
An Element of Dawn.
And yet it moves. A piece, emission, or work of the Dawn Machine.
Strange.
Okay. I think...
Oh-ho!
I think I need to head straight back to Palmerston.
That Hunter's Eye. It's, transcendently gross. But yeah, the Hunter's Eye happens to have a strange color to it.
You don't say.
As many secrets in my half of every knowledge grows.
Blimigan Colony. Ooh, 37% chance, 57% chance. Armed sailors settled behind a rise in the ground at the bog's edge. On your signal, they open fire into the purple mass. Dozens of Blimigans fall, but hundreds remain. They seethe across the bog, leaping across black gaps of standing water, maws agape. But you direct your crew's fire with calm and precision, and only a few reach the line. Your crew methodically smash them with rifle stocks and advance with caution towards the bog. The Blimigans which remained to defend the mound are no match for your weaponry. You take the mound without a single fatality, and they die, chittering curses. Of course, now you're possessed of a mound of mud. You find nothing of value, although the Blimigans apparently collected little clay tablets marked with indecipherable chicken scratchings. Your quartermaster, however, points out that the Blimigan bodies can be rendered into a purple dye, which will fetch a good price almost anywhere. 30 echoes.
I preferred to observe them. Oh, well.
Yeah.
Chance of failure was too high.
Yep.
I wonder if failure of the Mirror's Challenge would be less nasty than failure of the Iron Challenge.
I don't know. Let's... Codex Wither Vendorbite. Assuming nothing nasty awaits us halfway.
As is so often the case.
And that's a Faustian Corsair. Faustic, rather.
Which can just go back on its little patrol.
Can go to hell. With that. Nope, 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 nope. That's a Lifeberg. Stay over there. Intelligence, explore the town, try the grilled troglodyte prawns. Cool. Gonna stop at Vendorbite first.
Because it's money.
Let's gather up the corpses.
Chuck them in the stew.
Gather gossip. First curator, give it the hunter's eye. My left eye is blind. I should replace it with this one. It will be no blinder, but perhaps I will see within. It raises the hand with the hunter's eye towards its concealed face. No sound is indescribable, but some should be. This is one. Let us not trouble ourselves with its nuances. Its reminders of marsh and gangrene and chrysalid emergence. Take, it says, its voice ragged. It gestures at a side table where a spire tusk sits. A pearl tiara is perched jauntily atop the tusk. Both, apparently, are yours. A new captivating treasure and a hunting trophy. Nice. Explore Vendorbite. Gained a Tale of Terror and 10 fragments.
Unorthodox technology.
Sweeter scents draw you into a shop which sells candles. Lilac, lavender, honey. You fall into a discussion of their manufacture with the shopkeeper. Yes, she says, proudly displaying her missing arm, we render ourselves to good end. Oh, don't look like that. Our fats are of a finer quality than any other. And we grow tired of our bodies down here. Oops. While I'm passing, I'll clear a little more of the map.
Maybe pick up some exploration fragments you missed before.
Yeah. Like that.
Davies Bay. The prick finger wastes. Davies Bay, it looks like it's settled. Hello, Barnes. Looks like it feels a little bit too low.
Nothing to hide. Someone wants to sign on. Another day, a free evening. The Brass Embassy. This is Hell's foothold in London. It's warm, bright, and handsome. Every window blazes with light. There is a screech abruptly cut off from the Excruciation Annex. Pass on the wistful Devilus's information. The Devilus has provided intelligence from inside the Brimstone Convention, the aristocrat exiles of Hell. Hell will, no doubt, be interested. An urbane devil ushers you into a copper-paneled interview room. There are hunting prints on the walls, but the hunters are devils and their quarry women and men. The devil listens, fingers steepled, to your story, nodding encouragingly. That's terribly helpful of you. Terribly helpful. Could I have the message, please? He reads it with interest. Oh, that's very good. Allow me to offer a consideration to you here for your trouble. Bring me more and I'll give you something else. But do you mind performing some independent verification? You know how expats can get. Sometimes their imagination runs away with them. Anyway, here's a little present for your source. A gift for the wistful devilus? Now 50 you have carried intelligence to the Brass Embassy. Strategic information. Court reports. Gator's Mourn. Hunter's Keep. Mount Palmerston. Venderbite. Wither. Chapel of Lights. There's something about the Untersee that breeds heresy and dissent. I rather think we might need to send the Bishop of Southwark out for a good bit of Christian shouting.
Southwark or South Korea?
Avatar Horizon, I hope you intend to tell me that everything is quiet there. A visit from Mr. Sachs, of course. Khan's Heart. Frostfound. Codex. Oh god, what tense is it written in? Oh god, look, just read it to my colleague here, he'll give you your fee. I'll be over there when you're done. Wither is the next contact.
Trivial.
Easy enough. Okay, for ease of starting next week, could you make note of need to go to Wither, and I need to take 200 echoes to the funging station, to Demo's Gate. Before I proceed, lodgings. Read the morning papers. Time with family. Can give them a souvenir, an outlandish artifact. I need those, though.
We all need to go to Wither for intel, take 200 echoes to the funging station, and maybe 300 to Polythream for claiming.
Yes. That is definitely another thing I need to do. Let's tell tales of far lands. Lost 20 terror. 5 more Z fever.
Oh no, it's Mr. Sachs!
Mm-hmm.
He's here. He knows what you've done.
Thank you.
One more secret and I can make a shrine to stone.
Whatever they'll do for you.
Oh, okay, yeah. The process of creating the shrine to stone will increase your hearts by 7, and the shrine is an auxiliary item worth a further 7.
14 hearts? Nice.
Mm-hmm. 7 innate, 7 equipped. The anatomical cabinet is the same for iron. The serene aquarium is the same for mirrors.
That's resolved there for pages. Let's bring trappy case for veils. Yes, yes. When the bones are in place, you'll hear them when you sleep.
All right. And I would say to record the gift for the wistful Devilus, but we see her often enough anyway.
Why does it look like it's a fly?
It's a fly.
It's just a big old horsefly.
Mm-hmm. So, thank you for watching, everybody. We will be back on Saturday at 9 p.m. Eastern for Stone of Graves, where, if we have John, we will be continuing Layers of Fear. If we do not, we will be continuing Observer. Early Grave probably won't be happening given how I've been feeling, but we shall see. And then, of course, next Thursday, 9 p.m. Eastern, Thursday Thanatopsis with more Sunless Sea. Sunken was the word that my brain was stuck on.
Sunken London.
Sunken London. Sure.
Never mind, it's fallen on. Apparently the whole town was stolen by bats.
So thank you again, and I hope to see you next time.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.